So now we're going to look at three different formulations of a workable parallel histogram implementation. Now, you might be looking at this serial code and thinking, why can't we just unroll the serial loop n times and launch a thread for each iteration of the loop? Note if there's n measurements taken, we can consider launching n threads, each of which increments one bin count. It turns out this doesn't work, and it's important to understand why. So Dave already covered this topic in the last unit, so you can feel free to zip through this part if you totally understand it already. Anyway, we're going to take a look at this particular kernel, this naive histo kernel. In this kernel, each thread will be responsible for classifying one element and incrementing the histogram bin corresponding to that element. So let's look at this very simple kernel. In this code, the first thing we're going to do is compute our global ID. Then we're going to fetch our item from global memory. Then we're going to calculate which bin our item is associated with. And in this case, we're just using a very simple mod operator to do it. And finally, we're going to increment the bin with which our item is associated. Now, if we scroll down to the main routine here, we see that we have 65,000 elements that we're going to classify into 16 bins. So we would expect 4,096 items per bin. So what happens when we run this? So I'm going to run this kernel on a workstation that I'm connected to in our lab. So let's run this histo executable. And what we're going to see are the bin counts that we see for each bin. We expected 4,096 items per bin, and we're not getting anywhere close to 4,096 items per bin. In fact, we'll run it again. And if you note, these bin counts are even changing from iteration to iteration. So what's going on here? Let's go back and look at the most important instruction in the kernel, the one where we increment the value in the bin. So let's look at what's actually going on here. What does each thread program actually do if we implement the simple serial algorithm in parallel? It does three separate operations. The first one is doing a global memory read to fetch the bin value into a register. The second thing is it increments the bin value within the register. And the third thing is storing the incremented value back to global memory. Let's illustrate how this could go wrong. Consider two threads running in parallel. One, the black thread, two, the red thread. Both want to increment the same bin, this blue bin here that starts off with the value 5. Both threads happen to be running at the same time. So the first reads the value of the bin into its local register. Then the second reads the value of the bin into its local register. Both increment the value in their own local registers. Then the first writes its value back to global memory, storing a 6, and the second does the same, also a 6. And now we've got a problem, since we'd really like the answer 7. The fundamental issue here is called a race condition. The problem is that incrementing the value in global memory takes multiple steps, and it's possible, as we've seen here, for two processors running simultaneously to interleave these steps. Note that this is not going to happen in the serial code, because in the serial code, each iteration of the loop runs separately, and there's no danger of one thread's code running at the same time as another thread's code. So the simple solution doesn't work. So now let's look at three different ways that we might implement this in parallel that will work. All three of these methods are good parallel methods. None are obviously better or worse, and we'll talk about their pros and cons as we describe them.